Welcome to the 2020-2021 school year. This year we are doing Lobo Con, and you will have two hosts today for your presentation. I'm Elizabeth Lara, and this is...
I'm Chad Seitz. Hello. Welcome, Lobos. Looking forward to our 2020-2021 school year and getting the chance to meet everybody. Obviously, first we got to have a brief orientation with you, and so without any further delay, we'll go ahead and get things rolling.
All right, folks, so the first thing that I want to let you know is that this is a video, which means that the links aren't going to be interactive. However, when the presentation is over, we will be sending out an email address with the link to the PowerPoint, at which time you will be able to click on the links and review the presentation on multiple times. All right, so here we go. Let me share my screen. Guys, here we go. So normally, we would have a Lobo camp for our freshman students. However, because we're all in the same boat and we're all trying to figure this out together, this is Lobo Con 2020, and it is here for freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors, as well as parents. Hope you guys enjoy.
Go Lobos.
Now, in this presentation, you are going to listen to a welcome video from our proud principal, Mrs. Zuniga. You are going to get to meet and see the faces of our academic dean and your assistant principals, learn who your counselor is, read about our mission, vision, values, and pack mentality at Lehman High School, review who can come to Lehman for on-campus virtual learning, and review attendance and grading guidelines. In addition to this, you're going to learn the behavior expectations, obtain some tips for success, we're going to access a Schoology tutorial, and last but not least, you're going to enjoy the Lehman Love performance by your administration.
All right, and now an introduction by our campus leader and proud principal, Ms. Karen Zuniga.
Hello, Lobos. I'm Karen Zuniga, proud principal at Lehman High School. I am super excited to start a new year with you, finally. I look forward to meeting all of our new and returning Lobos. I know our staff and our teachers have been working extremely hard to ensure the safety of everyone on campus and also to ensure a great, wonderful learning experience for all of you. I know that at Lehman High School, we take pride in everything that we do. And I know our motto is achieving excellence as one with integrity, wisdom, and pride. And when you're a Lobo, you will achieve habits of excellence that creates opportunities for all students. Here we have a culture of continuous improvement and a growth mindset. I'm excited to introduce our new virtual way of getting information to you. It's called Lobo Con. You will learn about the people here, the academic dean, the assistant principal, and of course your counselors. You will learn about the mission and the vision and our values. You'll see what pack mentality means to us. You'll also learn a little bit about behavior expectations, grading policies, and attendance. And you'll even get some tips for success and even more. Let's remember, the strength of Lehman High School is each and every Lobo. And the strength of each and every Lobo is Lehman High School. I hope you enjoy LoboCon. Have fun and welcome back, Lobos. And remember, every day is a great day to be a Lobo.
Now, will you hear a brief message from our academic dean, Ms. Lytle?
Hi, Lobos. I'm Ms. Lytle. I'm your academic dean, and I am in charge of pretty much everything academics. If you have questions about anything pertaining around academics, go ahead and shoot me an email, or once you're back on campus, come see me in my office. Welcome back.
Next is yours truly and Ms. Lara here, who are speaking to you live. Get a brief little introduction and video from us. And, you know, it doesn't matter. I know we're both over the freshmen, but by all means, anybody from any grade level, come by and say hello. If you ever need anything, reach out to either one of us. We'll be happy to help.
Hi, Lobos. My name is Chad Seitz. I'm one of the new assistant principals here at Lehman High School. I'll be working in the freshman center, but certainly looking forward to meeting everybody here on campus. So when you guys come back, make sure you stop by and say hello. Until then, you guys take care. Stay safe.
Hi, Lobos. Welcome to the 2020-2021 school year. I am Mrs. Lara, one of the freshman assistant principals. If you ever need me, no matter what grade, please feel free to stop me. Have a great year, Lobos. For our sophomores, juniors, and seniors, here are our assistant principals. We have Mr. Hodges, Mr. Gonzalez, and Mr. Pisania. Stay tuned for a couple of videos from them.
Hey, Lobos. I want to introduce myself real quick. My name is Jay Hodges. I'm an assistant principal here at Lehman. I will be working primarily with upperclassmen whose alphabet falls in the front half, so A through G. And please feel free to come say hi if you see me on campus. You'll see me at lunch every day. You'll see me in the hallways. Welcome to Lehman if you're going to be new on campus. And for those of y'all that have been here, can't wait to see you guys. Stay well, and we'll see y'all soon. Bye.
Hello, Lobos. My name is Mr. Gonzalez. I'm one of the assistant principals here at Lehman High School. I want to say hello to everyone. This year, I'll be working with Mr. Cisneros and Mr. Smits as one of the senior sponsors, but I'll be able to assist anybody in our building. I look forward to seeing everyone in person, 6 feet away, and making sure that we're washing and sanitizing our hands. If you guys need anything, please come and see me. I look forward to seeing everybody and giving everybody high fives, air high fives. Thank you, guys. Talk to you soon.
Welcome back, Lobos. My name is Mr. Pisania. I am the assistant principal here at Lehman High School for the CTE department. But if there's anything you need or anything I can help you with, don't hesitate to ask. Look me up. I'll be around the area.
All right, next, you're going to want to get acquainted with the counseling team here at Lehman High School, who are top notch. These people here are going to help guide you through your endeavors and journey at high school at Lehman, get you on the pathway of success. Pay attention to the grade level and the alpha assignment here as they go through, and I'll read them very briefly. Ninth grade A through L, you guys are with Ms. Heiser. Ninth grade M through Z, Mr. Zabunkus. I'm probably mispronouncing that name, but nonetheless, you guys find out where that gentleman is and he'll be happy to help you. 10th grade through 12th grade, Alpha A through G-O-N-Z, Ms. Gomez. Alpha G or good through O, 10th through 12th grade, you guys are with Ms. Danford. And 10th through 12th grade, P through Z, that's your lead counselor, that's Mr. Barker. And then for 10th through 12th ESL and Spanish speaking, Ms. Yolanda Meja. Am I saying that correctly? Yeah. All right. And college and career counselor is Ms. Sabrina Perez. Definitely want to get in touch with her as you continue on and get ready for those post-secondary adventures that everybody's going to be looking forward to. And our outreach counselor on our campus is Ms. Renee Contreras.
You can click on the team and get to see their pictures. All right, guys. So our mission, vision, and values. The mission of Lehman High School, the heart of a proud and dynamic community, empowers learners for lifelong achievement. Our vision is achieving excellence with wisdom, pride, and integrity. And our values, along with integrity, wisdom, and pride, our Lehman community values commitment, compassion, honesty, and perseverance.
All right, on-campus virtual learning, for those of you that have signed up for and got reached out to by staff here at Lehman High School, and you're going to be on campus doing your virtual learning from September 8th, that's Tuesday of next week, through September 28th. Just a quick notes here, the only students that have signed up for this and who are on our list will be allowed to participate in our virtual learning on campus. All other students, you guys will be staying at the house and learning from home there in the comfort of your living room, bedroom, maybe it's in your backyard, who knows. Nonetheless, we're going to have a good time and get the virtual learning part out of the way and then move on and see what happens next.
All right. So the big question, extracurriculars. All students enrolled in virtual instruction are eligible to participate in UIL activities. The UIL guidelines will be followed for all aspects of extracurricular activities. Now attached here, we do have a link for the Hayes CISD 2020-2021 COVID-19 information regarding to extracurricular activities and UIL. When you click on the link, just go ahead and scroll down to page 29, and that's where you can get any additional information.
All right, synchronous versus asynchronous. I know you may have been introduced to these terminologies here whenever we had our closure back at during spring break. But just to kind of make sure we all have a working definition or operational definition of what these two words mean, in the next slide, you'll see the words synchronous and asynchronous. Synchronous refers to interactive online learning with the teacher and the peers. So that means you're kind of doing something with somebody, your teacher or peers, on the virtual learning model or experience. Asynchronous means you're not online with anybody and you're kind of working at your own pace alone, you know, in, like I say, in the comfort of your home somewhere.
So here's a daily schedule, and we don't know if you've already seen it because it has been published through our HCISD documents. However, we wanted you to take a look at it. What's very important about these schedules, guys, is that you need to notice that we have a Monday through Thursday schedule, and then we have a Friday schedule. So you want to go ahead and you want to make sure that you pay attention to that. Now, it is our understanding that schedules have gone out, but you don't have to worry about when your classes are going to be loaded in Schoology. The district is going to be doing that for you soon. As far as extracurricular practice, that's for our folks that are in UIL or any type of sports, cheer, dance, etc. So if you're not in those, you might not have that on your schedule. Transition time and breakfast is going to be from 8:15 to 9 o'clock, and that will be on your own time. You will have intervention and enrichment sessions, and that will be loaded into your schedule. Okay, some of you guys might have a morning session, some of you guys might have an afternoon session. So make sure that you're looking at your schedule for more information on that. And then on Fridays, you're actually gonna go to all 7 of your periods, and you will get to follow that unique schedule as well.
And just also, I'm
so sorry.
No, it's okay. Pay attention there. Like we said, the words synchronous and asynchronous were outlined. I'm sure Ms. Laura detailed that, but I just wanted to reiterate the synchronous and asynchronous vocabulary there to the right of all these, and just note those. Hey, good luck. If you need any help, certainly reach out to any of us up here at the campus as you're navigating through any of these schedules. And so the next schedule.
All right. So go ahead, Ms. Price.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'll take this one.
We're both so excited to be showing this to our kids.
So our next schedule is going to be when we return back to campus, or those of us that have elected to come back to in-person learning on September the 28th. And as we resume school and as normal as it is these days, right, this is what we'll be looking at in terms of a schedule. You can tell first period, second period, third period, fourth period. The start time is a little different, as you might have noted back on the previous schedule. Classes began a little bit later, but here we're going to get going at 8:40. And as we go through those classes, the next period starts at 9:38, 10:38, 11:36, so on and so forth. And then if you'll note down at the lunch and fourth period, what we have here is what we're going to implement is an advisory period during fourth. And so we'll utilize that on a daily basis for different needs. You know, we'll do that certainly for some outreach and you know, getting to have some time to just get to know you. Also with our integrity and wisdom and our 7 mindsets and those types of things are going to be implemented at this point. But we do this because we have to maintain our social distancing as best that we can with our 3 lunch model here. And you can note kind of what areas based on your fourth period assignment of the building are going to be assigned to A, B, or C lunch, all right? Then fifth period, sixth period, and seventh period are as follows there on our schedule. And you can tell because of our delayed start in terms of the calendar, you know, we are, and you probably already know this, there was communication sent out by our district that our school day is going to be a little bit longer than what it's been in the past. And if you'll note the end time at 4:30 p.m. every day, just something to put back of your minds there to get familiar with and get comfortable with and make sure that you know, reach out and organize appropriately your departure here, any pickup or anything that you might need. Now, all that being said, the 2 schedules that Ms. Laura and I just showed you here and went into detail about, just keep in mind, those are certainly subject to change and they could be, but we'll certainly make you guys aware of that as needed. But just to kind of give you a little bit of a preface here and see what it's about, you know, here it is. And like always, you know, reach out with any questions or inquiries about any of this. All right.
Right. Attendance. Guys, this is super, super important. In order to receive a credit in a class, whether it's synchronous or asynchronous, which means, you know, virtual or in person, you must attend at least 90% of the time per class semester. So, you know, a lot of you guys are going to have the option to be at home, or you've chosen to be at home. You need to make sure that you log in for the day to make sure that you are getting credit. The last thing that you want is to, you know, complete all of your assignments, but because you weren't in class when you were supposed to be, that you don't receive credit. So if you attend less than 90% of the time in a class per semester, a plan will be put in place to fulfill your requirements for owed hours. And who wants to spend extra time here or give up your lunch or give up any of your time for that owed time if you can be here? So all absences, whether excused or unexcused, can keep you from receiving credit for class. So you want to make sure that, you know, if you're absent, you're still, you know, bringing in your notes, you're communicating with your teachers and letting them know what's going on. But most importantly, guys, especially for those of you guys that are doing virtual learning, you want to make sure that you're logging in so that you are being counted present.
All right. And so, of course, just as important as our attendance is the grading and the grading guidelines that you need to get yourself familiar with, right? So we've attached a link here, the HACISD grading guidelines that will apply. Students will receive true grades for the assignments in both synchronous and asynchronous learning. It will not be a pass-fail grading system like you were familiar with at the break of last spring semester when we all got out for spring break and had to have the closure model there with our at-home learning. So just be prepared for a more rigorous learning experience and know that you're going to have to probably set aside a little bit more time for studying and preparing and all that that implies and just get ready for a little bit more of a comprehensive learning experience, whether it be online or here in person. So at minimum, students will have three major grades per grading period and one minor grade per week. That's probably pretty familiar to you based on what we used to apply for our grading scale whenever you guys were here in person and what you've experienced in the past, whether you're coming from a middle school or whether you've been here the last 1, 2, or 3 years. The breakup of these grades will be by the teacher discretion. So that teacher's going to, you know, get to apply how they want to break those grades up and apply them to the grading policy, you know, within the HACISD guidelines, of course. You must pass your class with an overall average of a 70 or higher to receive credit for the class. And so, you know, our freshmen that are coming in, you know, you guys really got to familiarize yourself. And I would say this is where you reach out to your counseling team and your assigned counselor and make sure that you understand that credits are extremely important at the high school level. You have to acquire so many credits in order to achieve graduation. All of our courses, virtual or in person, will apply to the student's high school transcript and GPA. Okay, so just make sure that this is all subject and you are aware of how this applies to our TEA guidelines. TEA now, that's not a drink, right? I know everybody probably likes to have a little sip from time to time of some tea, but that's Texas Education Agency is what that stands for. And so you might, you know, reach out and take a look at that website, Mom, Dad. You guys might want to familiarize yourself with that, but, you know, certainly Hayes is in alignment with all the Texas Education Agency guidelines. And if you have any aspirations of looking at that, by all means, you know, take a peek at it.
All right. Behavior expectations. So we're always going to follow the student code of conduct first and foremost, whether in person or virtual. Disciplinary issues are going to be, we're going to look at them through the student code of conduct. So make sure that you get yourself familiar with that. It seems like a really long, you know, PDF, but at the same time, you need to know what is expected of you. Now, some additional expectations that we have here at Lehman for you are for you to follow your daily school schedule, whether it's either in person or virtual. Give your best efforts on your school assignments. Actively participate in face-to-face learning activities or live virtual sessions as instructed by teachers. Be organized in your work and in getting projects completed. Ask questions and communicate with your teachers. Be aware of what you should be learning each day and turn in all assignments on time.
All right, a few tips for success besides just those things that Ms. Laura was talking about in the behaviors and expectations. Set alerts for your student self-service portal. Check it daily, you know, check it multiple times a day. If you haven't gotten yourself familiar with that, certainly, you know, reach out and get yourself very familiar with that piece. It's going to be extremely helpful. You can monitor your success, track your assignments and things like that. It's a good way to stay on top of things and stay organized and stay on the track of success. Advocate for yourself and ask for help as needed. I mean, advocating for ourselves is something that, you know, starts as early as a freshman or before then. And we want to do that regularly and, you know, certainly ask for help as needed. This is a interesting time for all of us, for the the staff that's here, administration, teachers, everybody. So we are in uncharted territories. There's going to be a ton of questions. We have questions, but certainly there's never an experience here where we're going to think anybody's asking too many questions or a question that shouldn't be asked. Ask away. We'll be happy to help. And things that we don't know about, we'll tell you up front and we'll get answer to those as soon as we can. Like we said before, get to know that counselor. Have that mentality of attitude of gratitude, right? So be grateful for the fact that, you know, we're getting this opportunity to get an experience, to be back together with each other. Might be in a little bit different dynamic, a different model, but nonetheless, hey, we get to be here. And I know I'm grateful for that. I want everybody here to feel comfortable about the experience they get to have at Lehman High School. I want you to know that we have got the top-notch, number one, superb team of teachers and faculty staff here at Lehman High School, and we're here to serve you, work in your favor, and help you, you know, navigate through this thing called high school as best that we all can. Think about having some passion when you're doing things. Lead by example. Be accountable. You know, be responsible. You know, you're at that age where people start to look at us and think that you know they're going to hold us to a higher level of accountability and think that we need to be a little more responsible about our actions, behaviors, things that we say, things that we do. You know, and certainly that's going to be the case, like we referenced the code of conduct on the previous slide. You know, it all applies to the virtual learning. So make sure that we're all doing what's in the best interest of everybody here as part of the Lobo family. And we want everybody to certainly be a part of our family and abide by the rules, regulations, and our policies. And if you have a question about any of them, hey, reach out, ask. We'll be happy to fill you in. There's a lot of unknowns, but we want to try to cover them as best we can. And remember, everything is possible. Okay, you guys, there's tons of potential on this campus. I know that's going to be learning from this campus virtually, and we're going to help you reach that potential, whatever that is. That does take some responsibility on your part and holding yourselves accountable, but we're certainly going to do whatever we can to help get you where it is that you're trying to achieve to.
All right. Okay. So as I've, you know, scrolled through Facebook and I've talked to several parents and actually several students too, the big question is Schoology. It's new. How am I supposed to use it? What am I supposed to do? So on this page, guys, there's going to be several different links. And several of these videos were prepared by our very own digital coach, Brandy Sneed. And she walks you through on how to log into Schoology. It's going to be a bit easier if you have one of our devices, because you're going to log into Schoology through ClassLink. And for ClassLink, it just takes, you know, your lunch number, your student ID as your login, your student ID as your password. But if you don't have one of our devices, then there's also a video on there that tells you what it is that you need to do so that you can access ClassLink. So ClassLink, folks, is, if you don't remember, it's kind of like a housing system where all of the different apps that you are using for school are housed. Now, in one of the videos, it does talk about a QR quick card that your teacher might have given you. Some of you guys might still have it from last year. Some of you guys might not. But if you don't have it, don't fret. If you click on the link that says, even if you have an iPad, if you click on the link that says logging into ClassLink, it'll tell you the actual site or the link that you need to go to so that you can download ClassLink, whether you are on iPad, Chromebook, laptop, or desktop. So these are going to be very, very useful for you. In addition to logging into ClassLink, now that you've gotten in there, then these are some Schoology tutorials that have been prepared for you. So it's the overview of Schoology, how to get in, how to walk around, how to set your default view to your course dashboard, messaging a teacher, how to record audio or video, responding to a discussion, how to submit an assignment in Schoology, and checking your grades. Now, all of these are in student view, parents. So if you're a parent and you're watching this, there is a Schoology tutorial for parents, and it you can find that on the Hey CISD COVID-19 plan. There are links for that. I won't click into all of these because, you know, this does take some time, and I do want to give you guys the opportunity to click in and open the videos, but very, very helpful information. Another important thing is, students, you don't have to worry about adding your classes. Our system is going to add those classes for you. So when you open up Schoology, maybe not today and maybe not tomorrow, but sometime by the end of this week, you guys are going to be able to log into Schoology and your classes should already be built in for you. Okay, so we are, our district is working feverishly to try to get this to you, but we thought these would be great links and resources for you to get familiar with Schoology.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff, Ms. Laura, on that Schoology piece.
That's a lot of stuff, Mr. Seitz.
But I know that I'm certainly glad I've got somebody on my team like you and the other folks like Ms. Sneed that are super knowledgeable about that stuff to kind of coach us up on it, because I would be overwhelmed. But I know that also in reality, these young people we're talking to are far more tech savvy than some old guy like me. So, but like Laura said, and yeah, hey, get on there, fiddle around with that stuff, ladies and gentlemen, and get yourself familiar with it. You're going to do just fine with it. You know, we'll be patient. I know everybody's been patient with me on stuff like that for sure. Ask your teachers questions, help each other out if you need to. And hey, we're in this together. Just remember that.
So guys, we prepared, and when I say we, I am talking about your administration team, all of, your assistant principals, your academic dean, and your principal prepared what we call the Layman Love video. So I am going to click on this, and I want you guys to enjoy it, and we worked really, really hard on it. So we hope that you have as much fun watching it as we had making it, and after the conclusion of the video, then we will come back and just do our final goodbyes. So here you go.
Proud, proud principal.
Welcome back, Lobos.
Lobos, this year we got you. There are some things we should do, like washing your hands and checking all y'all's temperature.
Using hand sanitizer, sanitizer, staying 6 feet apart.
Put on your masks, keep up our mentality. Buses out back, do this drop off and parking.
Bring your IDs, that's something you have to wear. Lobos just know, we're showing that we care.
Every day in every way, we have to stay away. 6 feet.
Maybe love, mentality, integrity.
Lobos, Layman Lobos, Layman Lobos,
Well, I just got to say that right there was an amazing video, and props probably to the Lobo himself for best dance moves out there. I just got to say that's just,
I would agree. Louis did a great job. He has those dance moves for sure, and he definitely keeps our spirits up.
Yeah, he wins that award for sure.
All right, guys. So thank you for your time. Thank you for watching the video. We hope that this answered a lot of your questions. A link to this presentation is going to be sent via email tonight. In that presentation, you will be able to click on the links. So if you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to reach out to us.
All right. Looking forward to seeing everybody. You guys take care of yourselves. See you soon. Go Lobos.
Go Lobos.